The hadith says, and it comes to my mind now, يُقَالُ لِصَاحِبِ الْقُرْآنِ on the day of Qiyamah, a person who's made an effort to memorize and put into practice part of the Qur'an, if not all of it, it will be said to him, اِقْرَأْ وَارْتَقِ وَرَتِّلْ كَمَا كُنْتَ تُرَتِّلُ فِي الدُّنْيَا فَإِنَّ مَنْزِلَكَ عِنْدَ آخِرِ آيَةٍ تَقْرَأُهَا. Do you know what that means? Amazing. It says, the person will be told on the day of judgment, read, recite as you used to in the dunya. That's why I told you read melodiously in the dunya, please. Because if you get to the akhirah and you are one of those who just used to say dhalin in salah, then you will be from amongst the dhalin. You know what that means? There is an imam, they call him Sheikh Ferrari. Why Ferrari? Because not because he comes from Harari, no. But because he reads so quick in Taraweeh. Some people have a disease. They follow the masajid which are fast. Hey, that one finishes at 12 minutes past 9. No, this one's 10 past 9. Hey, this one's 8 minutes past. A'udhu billah. Is that how you're teaching the Quran? Wallahi, the people who look at the clock are far away from the Quran. They are far away from Allah. You need to look at the quality, the raha. This is the word of Allah. How dare you want to look at the clock? Allahu Akbar. May Allah forgive us. So this man, you only hear him. He says, Allahu Akbar. You hear him say that. And after a while, Al-Dallin. That's the only thing you hear is Dallin. So I say he is Minat Dallin. He's from amongst those who are astray. What is the meaning of Dallin? It's the only word I heard. It means astray. So he's astray. Allahu Akbar. May Allah forgive us. The Quran, if you read it melodiously, beautifully in the dunya, you will only be able to read on the day of judgment how you used to read whilst you were in the world. كَمَا كُنْتَ تُرَتِّلُ فِي الدُّنْيَا. Read how you used to read in the dunya. فَإِنَّ مَنْزِلَكْ عِنْدَ آخِرِ آيَةٍ تَقْرَأُهَا. You keep on going up as you read. One verse, one level. Second verse, next level. Third verse, next. And you keep on going up. And your final abode, your final status and place will be upon the last verse that you get to. Allahu Akbar. So now if you look at the explanation of that, it's quite deep. Where it's not only my memorization was strong and solid. What's the point of having, I don't make any mistakes in the whole Quran, cover to cover, but you're not practicing upon it, you know? So when it comes to what, in the first Surah Baqarah, it says, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ. Neither did we do ruku', nor did we do salah, so we will get stuck at that verse. Stuck. Why? Because you didn't practice upon this verse. It's right at the beginning. Allahu Akbar, may Allah make it easy for us. This is the Quran. Beautiful words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you find topics changing as the rhythm changes. But here we are, we don't even know that. We haven't even made an effort. We don't even know what's going on. I hope and I pray we can change that. And these few words, I hope that they are words of motivation for you and I. I really hope and pray that they are words of motivation for you and I.
And now all we live for is, you know, toys and pleasures. That's all we live for now, is entertainment. That's what we've become. And so at the end of it all, nothing you earn, nothing I earn is worth anything on Judgment Day except that light. This is why when this passage began, Allah Azza wa Jalla described it with light. And that light is the only thing that matters on Judgment Day. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى رَبَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. The one who comes before Allah with a sound heart, the heart that can beam light in front of them. Anything else that you and I have, that we have now, is worthless. It's completely worthless before Allah on Judgment Day. You can enjoy it for now, but if you get caught up in it and it takes up the space in your heart, then you have no room left for light in your heart. You just don't have room left. Which is why the last ayah of this passage is فَالْيَوْمَ لَا يُؤْخَذُ مِنْكُمْ فِدْيَةٌ وَلَا مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مَأْوَاكُمُ النَّارُ هِيَ مَوْلَاكُمْ وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ. And today, there's not going to be any compensation, any ransom acceptable from you. Don't try to pawn it for anything else. There is no access into those doors. There's no getting through this door with any kind of penalty or payment. You can't get through. Not from you and not from those who've disbelieved. The scary part of this ayah is لا يُخَذُ مِنْكُمْ فِدْيَةٌ وَلَا مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. You are now in the same position as those who disbelieved. You ended up being in the same position as those who disbelieved. I'm not going to take any ransom from you, and I'm not going to take any ransom from them. All of you, your place is fire. وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ. What a terrible place to be that is. And so at the end of it all, after painting this scene, Allah concludes. And I'll conclude with this ayah as well. How is it that we can continue to preserve our light? and continue to remind ourselves not to put ourselves in that downward spiral. And whatever little light we have, how can we make it stronger and stronger and stronger? Allah Azza wa Jalla Himself says, أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Isn't it yet time that believers' hearts should become, their hearts should become filled with awe, with the remembrance of Allah? Truly remembering Allah will bring awe into the hearts. And the more your hearts remember Allah, because Allah Himself is Nuru Samawati wal Ard, Allah is the light of the skies and the earth, the more Allah is in your heart, the more light is inside your heart. You understand? So he says, remember Allah. And then he says, how do you remember Allah? This is called Ataf Bayan in Arabic. وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. And they should be filled with awe because of what came down from the truth, because of the revelation, because of the Quran. Ponder over the Quran, remember Allah through the Quran, weep when you recite the ayat of Quran, think about what they mean to you, the gift that Allah has given you, because not only is Allah the light of the skies and the earth, the Quran itself is also described as light in the Quran. فَآمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَالنُّورِ الَّذِي أَنزَلْنَا. Believe in Allah and His Messenger and the light that we sent down. Quran itself is called light. Quran itself is called light. And so the amount of time you spend with the Book of Allah, personal, for your own personal benefit, for your own personal benefit, when you sit and recite it and ponder over it, and you think about what Allah your Master is saying to you, that is going to fill your heart with light. And there's no more, you know, greater a treasure in your life than that light. And you won't realize the price of it, I won't realize the price of it, until we stand on that day when everything around us is dark, and the only light is the light coming out of my chest, and the only light coming out of my hands. That's when we'll realize. وَلَا يَكُونُ كَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِ فَطَالَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَمَدِ فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. They shouldn't become like people who came a long time before them, who were given the book a long time before them, and a long period passed, and their hearts became hard. They had the book, but they didn't value it. It's possible, Allah says, that a nation will have a book. They will have the book of Allah. There were nations before us who had a book too. They had Torah, they had Injil. They had Suhuf Ibrahim and Musa. They had. But they didn't benefit from them. لَمْ يَنْتَفِعُوا مِنْهَا. They didn't benefit from those books. They didn't use those books to fill their hearts with light. Maybe they used those books for the wrong reasons. Maybe they reduced those books to just ceremonial occasions. They just enjoyed reciting it sometime every once in a while. You know, that's all it became to them. Or maybe at some wedding gathering they can play some Quran and that's all Quran became. But Quran was not there to soften their hearts anymore. And this is the tragedy of history. People did not benefit from the word of Allah that came to soften hearts, preparing humanity for standing before Allah on Judgment Day. That's our responsibility now. That's on you and that's on me. This is why وَلَا يَكُونُ كَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِ فَطَالَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَمَدِ فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. So their hearts became hard. Their hearts became hard. When the heart becomes hard, there's no light inside left. It's not going to give you anything on judgment. وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. Most of them are corrupt. Many of them are corrupt. Allah Azza wa Jalla is now in these few ayat painting one of the most important realities, depicting one of the most important realities in the life of a believer. The iman you and I have is not something we can hold on to. This light that we have been given is not something that's guaranteed. It's not. Just because you have it now and you feel secure, if somebody says salam to you, means they're Muslim, you say wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, they're both Muslims, they're believers to each other, we assume that we all have the light of faith inside our hearts. But according to these ayat, some people will stand up on judgment day and be shocked, I thought I was with you, and you're not. So we better realize that it's not automatic, it's not guaranteed, it's something you personally will have to make efforts for, I personally will have to make efforts for, and your iman will not help me and my iman will not help you on Judgment Day. We're all going to be caring about ourselves, our own light. Irji'u wara'akum faltamisu nura. Go back, find your own light. That's, and right now we can cooperate with each other. And right now we can strengthen each other's iman. But on that day, there's not going to be any help. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us of those who preserve the light in our hearts. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us of those who are not on the wrong side of that wall. Protect us and our families and our loved ones from nifaq. May Allah keep our hearts from becoming hard. And may Allah Azza wa Jal make us of those who continually internalize the word of Allah, allowing our hearts to soften and to be filled with light.
The second advocate of a person on the Day of Judgment, the second lawyer, is the book of Allah, the Quran. And that is accessible to every single one of us. The Quran will be given a voice on the Day of Judgment. It will be speaking with a sound that everybody can hear. And some people will enter paradise, and some people will enter hell because of the book of Allah, the Quran. Thus the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, as Imam Muslim narrates on the authority of Abi Umamah al-Bahili, he said, اقرأوا القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. Recite the Quran frequently because it will speak and defend and intercede for people on the Day of Judgment. Are there any particular chapters of the Quran that we must give special attention to? Yes, the hadith continues. اقرأوا الزهراوين البقرة وسورة آل عمران فإنهما يأتيان يوم القيامة كأنهما غمامتان أو كأنهما غيايتان أو كأنهما فرقان من طير صواف تحاجان عن أصحابهما. He said, give special attention to the two surahs of the Quran, Al-Baqarah and Ali Imran, chapter 2 and chapter 3 of the Quran, because they will come on the Day of Judgment in the form of two clouds, or in the form of two canopies, or in the form of two flocks of birds, and they will be arguing for their people on the Day of Judgment. They will be arguing on your behalf on the Day of Standing. The Quran will have a voice, dear brothers and sisters. This is a lawyer that every one of us can hire today. In the life of this world, we may not have the finances needed to hire the best of lawyers. As for the Quran, every Muslim is able to hire that book, i.e. to defend you on the Day of Judgment. Thus, Abi Huraira, the companion, would say, as Imam Ad-Darimi narrates in his Sunan, Abu Huraira, the companion, he said, اقرأوا القرآن فإنه نعم الشفيع يوم القيامة. Recite the Quran because it is the best intercessor on the Day of Judgment. He said, إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ لِرَبِّهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. The Quran will speak and it will say to Allah on the Day of Judgment, يَا رَبِّ حَلِّهِ حِلْيَةَ الْكَرَامَةِ فَيُحَلَّ حِلْيَةَ الْكَرَامَةِ. يَا رَبِّ كْسُهُ كِسْوَةَ الْكَرَامَةِ فَيُكْسَى كِسْوَةَ الْكَرَامَةِ. يَا رَبِّ أَلْبِسْهُ تَاجَ الْكَرَامَةِ فَيُلْبَسُ تَاجَ الْكَرَامَةِ. يَا رَبِّ ارْضَ عَنْهُ فَلَيْسَ بَعْدَ رِضَاكَ شَيْءٌ. The Quran will say, oh Allah, imagine you standing and in front of you is the book of Allah defending you and arguing your case, pleading with Allah to allow you to enter Jannah. The Quran will say, oh Allah, beautify him with the beauty of honor. So Allah will beautify you with the beauty of honor. Then the Quran will say, oh Allah, allow him to wear the garments of honor. So Allah will dress you with the garments of honor. Then the Quran will say, oh Allah, place on his head the crown of honor. And so Allah will place on his head the crown of honor. Then the Quran will say, oh Allah, be pleased with him. Oh Allah, accept him. Because this is the greatest ambition of any human being. Allahu Akbar. So what is our plan for the book of Allah? What is our daily relationship with the Quran? Wherever we go, dear brothers and sisters, let us ensure we have a copy of the Quran with us. Either in our pocket, in our handbag, in our rucksack, there is a strong relationship with the Quran and a 10-year plan with regards to its understanding through the Arabic language, with regards to its memorization, with regards to its application. We have a clear plan that we want to achieve within 5 to 10 years pertaining to the Book of Allah. By doing so, we are preparing our lawyers for the Day of Judgment.